been proven that 94% of life on Earth is aquatic, and about two-thirds of marine life are still to be identified. Today, we journey into the depths of the ocean to meet some of the most mysterious sea creatures. Number 21, Christmas tree worm. For these guys, it's Christmas every day. They look like the most colorful Christmas trees and were found on Lizard Island, just off the Great Barrier Reef. Sure, they look like fake Christmas trees, but who's judging? The Spirobranchus giganteus has these little branches which enable the worm to breathe and feed. If the worm is threatened, it withdraws its branch and hides in its little tube, and when he feels safe again, he emerges, just as glorious as before. Number 20, clown frogfish. You can't have a frown on your face if you're looking at one of these funny little fish. They're found off the coast of Bali, Indonesia, and they like to keep a low profile. They are masters of disguise and like to camouflage themselves to ensure no one spots them. With their stripes, warts, and spots, you'll often mistake a clownfish for a rock or a plant, so tread carefully. Number 19, bobbit worm. There's so much more to the bobbit worm than meets the eye. It's not called the bobbit worm for nothing. It got the name from Lorena Bobbitt, who found some fame in the 90s for chopping off her husband's you-know-what with a kitchen knife. It's a long story. This worm likes to do something similar. It waits patiently in the water with more than half its body in the sand. When unsuspecting prey comes along, the worm, alerted by the movement thanks to sensory bristles, jumps out and cuts its victim in half. Bear in mind, these worms can grow up to 10 feet in length, so their dinner doesn't stand a chance. Number 18, salp. Stringy colonies of salp are found in all parts of the ocean. These planktonic tunicates play a key role in the ocean. Salp have the ability to turn their own bodily waste into carbon packages that then help to remove carbon from the water's surface. Their abundance or distribution plays a role in climate change, according to experts. Number 17, sea cucumbers. Sea cucumbers are most certainly not to be eaten, and these flaccid, gross-looking organisms are quite the mystery to many. For one, they don't have a proper brain, although that hasn't stopped humans before, let alone sea cucumbers. Despite its obvious flaws, it plays a vital role in the oceanic ecosystem. It breaks down waste and recycles any nutrients that it encounters. They're exceptionally flexible, so they can hide in the tiniest crevices, and if things are just not looking good for them, it has the ability to self-mutilate and spews out its internal organs through its bottom to ward off predators. We'd probably run away from that, wouldn't you? Fortunately, they do grow back. Number 16, sea angel. It's hard to imagine this beautiful looking creature to be a predator, and with a name like sea angel, that's even more of a challenge. They're a type of sea snail that move through the waters like they're flying while hunting shelled pteropods. They're generally found in the cold Antarctic waters, but of late they've cropped up in warmer equatorial seas as well. Number 15, sea pens. Named so because they look like quill pens that we used to write with. These beautiful sea pens are colonies of the smallest tentacled polyp, which resemble little branches. They have a bulb which roots them to the seabed, but should the need arise for them to move, they are able to uproot themselves to do so. You can actually buy these for your home aquarium, and they're actually really challenging to keep alive. Number 14, sea spiders. No relative to our land spiders, sea spiders have no genetic connection to them at all. If you are hoping to avoid them, sadly for you, they're found in oceans around the world. And to add insult to injury, they are most certainly predators and at the very least, scavengers. They particularly enjoy sticking their proboscis into sea anemones and sucking out all the nutrients. Number 13, the flamingo tongue snail. If you're a shell collector, then note, this is not a shell you can add to your collection, although it certainly resembles one. It's the flamingo tongue snail's living mantle tissue. These beautiful snails are found in the Atlantic and the Caribbean, and they enjoy a diet of toxic sea fans. The snail can absorb the venom from the toxic sea fans and thereby become toxic itself, much to the dismay of the unsuspecting predator. Sadly, the decline of these snails is on the rise as they are being caught as souvenirs. Number 12, Crissota norvegica jellyfish. Spotted for the first time in 2005 out in the Arctic Ocean was this unusual species of jellyfish. With the aid of a remotely operated vehicle, this rare sight was captured at 8,530 feet below the surface. Just under an inch in size, these vibrant little jellyfish spend their entire life in the planktonic stage. Not too much is known about these bright jellyfish, but maybe it's only a matter of time. Number 11, red-lipped batfish. This unusual fish is puckered up and just waiting for you to plant a big one on his lips. They were discovered on the seafloor close to the Galapagos Islands. They've adapted to walk along the ocean floor with modified pectoral and pelvic fins. Their snout comes equipped with a retractable appendage, helping to lure its prey in. The bright red lips are believed to enhance species recognition during spawning. Number 10, flower hat jellyfish. These intriguing jellyfish are only found in a small area just off the coast of Japan. Since they were discovered, they've now found their way into aquariums, making it a lot easier to study them. They like to stay close to the ocean floor, and although they're not harmful to humans, their tentacles can cause a bit of a painful sting. They grow to about 6 inches in diameter and feed off little fish, which they poison and then hold tightly in their tentacles. When there's little food, they make themselves much smaller, so they require less food. Number 9. Red handfish. Quite like our red-lipped batfish from earlier, this red handfish also likes to walk across the ocean floor. They're common in southern Australia and Tasmania and grow between 2 and 5 inches. They have scales that cover their bodies called denticles, and this is said to be one of the rarest fish in the world. They lay their eggs at the bottom of seaweed, and with the constant movement, the eggs get jostled or knocked off. People also try to catch them and keep them as pets, with little success long-term. Number 8. Dorid nudibranch. Specifically, a Pectenodoris trilineata, which is a colorful species of sea slug. Nudibranches are truly the gems of the depths, as they come in the most incredible array of colors and textures. This one is a brilliant violet color with translucent white and red markings. They're found in the waters of Bali, the Philippines, Indonesia, and even the Great Barrier Reef. They feed on sponges, and studies have proven that they're able to generate sound, kind of like wiretapping against a jar, which is audible to humans. Number 7. Glass squid. There are 60 known species of glass squid who live in oceans all around the world. They're not too fussy. Either they're close to the surface or somewhere in the middle. The sizes of glass squid can vary greatly, from as little as 3.9 inches to as big as 9.8 feet. The transparency of the glass squid helps it to camouflage itself in the water. Of course, the squid has 8 arms, but 6 of them are short in comparison to the rest of its body. The squid is bioluminescent, with the light-producing organs found underneath the eyes. To give the squid buoyancy, there's a large chamber filled with ammonia that allows the squid to float beautifully. Number 6. Wobbegong. With a name like Wobbegong, how can we not include this creature? Part of the carpet shark family, this shark makes its home in the waters of the Western Pacific Ocean and the Indian Ocean. They spend most of their time resting on the ocean floor, and their fat, tasseled bodies provide the perfect camouflage. They like to feast on fish, crabs, octopi, and lobsters. The word Wobbegong is thought to stem from an Australian Aboriginal language, and these guys have been known to bite through wetsuits, often needing to be cut off, as once they bite, they do not let go. So, if you spot one in the water, just leave it alone. Number 5. Napoleon wrasse. Also known as a humphead wrasse, Maori wrasse, or Napoleon fish, there's no doubt that this fish is quite special. It's the largest reef fish you can find in the warmer waters of the Indian and Pacific Oceans, and the females can live to around 50 years, while the males live to roughly 45. Each fish has a unique pattern, just like our fingerprints. These fish can change from male to female, and it can take up to 9 years before a fish becomes male or female. They are on the list of highly endangered fish. Number 4. Stargazer. With a name like Stargazer, you kind of expect a fish that's a little more friendly looking than this one. This horrifying creature is found in the shallow waters of the Mediterranean Sea and in the Atlantic. They bury themselves in the sand, and all you can see poking out are these like creepy eyes. This fish can deliver an electric shock up to 50 volts thanks to poison spikes situated on its pectoral fins. They'll eat pretty much anything that crosses its path, and once they've swallowed their dinner, they simply burp the scales out. Number 3. Megamouth shark. This is a rather unusual looking version of a megamouth shark. First discovered in 1976, there have only been 55 sightings of megamouth sharks since then. They're usually black or dark brown and have dermal denticles, just like other shark species. It is a filter feeding shark, thank goodness, and can be found in the Indian, Atlantic, and Pacific Ocean. They can grow up to 17 feet and weigh as much as 2,600 pounds. Number 2. Venus flytrap anemone. It's easy to see why this interesting anemone has been called the Venus flytrap anemone, and it's found on the Gulf of Mexico. Like the flower, the anemone closes its tentacles over its prey, where it shuts itself up to protect itself. They vary in size. Some are a few inches, while there have been some as big as a foot. They're usually at depths of 1,500 and 5,000 feet, and they come in lovely shades of pink and orange. Number one, ribbon eel. No doubt about it, some ribbon eels are exceptionally pretty, and they are also able to switch from male to female. All ribbon eels start life out as male, but once they begin maturing, they begin to grow female parts. They're generally found in the Indo-Pacific Ocean, and they enjoy a meal of small fish, which they attract with their flared nostrils. As they grow older, they change from blue and yellow to a plain yellow, and often stay in the same hole for months on end. Which of our mysterious sea creatures was your favorite? Share your thoughts with us in the comments below and subscribe to our channel for more interesting videos just like this. Thanks for watching.